It's October. It's finally Halloween season. Very exciting. I have some fun stuff planned for today. I have some stuff off my new 3D printer, which I finally got all set up. I also have some fun stuff planned for streaming today for what jewelry we're going to make. We're going to make a charm bracelet with fruit lanterns on it. So instead of just doing a jack-o'-lantern, we're definitely going to do a banana lantern. We're definitely going to do a pumpkin. And then if you guys want other fruits, otherwise I'll just kind of decide maybe like a strawberry, maybe an apple. I can make an apple and cad pretty easy. Maybe a pear shape. So we're gonna make fruito lanterns today with our spooky Halloween music. Yeah. So today's been a really good day. The other thing is, if you are not new to my channel, you'll notice that there are some new buttons at the top of the screen. I became an affiliate today. Like an hour ago, I became an affiliate. So it was a pretty big deal. I'm really excited. And so, yeah, so now I can get subs. I'm going to get some sub stuff. I'm going to need some emotes. I'm going to have some fun stuff going on. So yay! Very, 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 very exciting today. I also have a Discord open, which I'll talk a little bit later on the stream as well. So if you've got design ideas, you should want to talk about CAD. I've created a server on there that we can use to talk about CAD. And, you know, design and kind of whatever else our little community wants to talk about. Yay! So, let's see. So today we're going to make fruit lanterns and talk about my 3D printer. So, let's talk about the 3D printer first. It's the wrong color. Good. So, the resin they sent me was green, and I realized it's probably going to be invisible on the stream. Oops. But that's okay. I didn't get to pick the color. They picked the color for me. So I will go ahead. I think, it looks like it. So there's a little bit of distortion on here. Oh no, it is invisible. Invisible jewelry. Ooh. Okay. I'll show those off a little later on the stream. I also have this. Yeah, totally invisible. Shouldn't have got the green. So I've been making spray paint and lighter. So I'll show those off a little later on the stream as well. So, let's go ahead and get started. So, we're going to start with a pumpkin, then a banana, and then whatever other fruit we want to work on. Let me go back into my corner. Boop, 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 boop. Bah. There we go. Okay. So, let's start with our standard jack-o'-lantern. We're going to do a pumpkin. Now, we have to decide how big we want these charms to be. If we want them to be big, we want them to be small. I'm thinking kind of like a medium size. Let me turn on my handy dandy calipers, and let's decide how big we want these to be. I'm thinking like a good size. That way we can kind of get details on there. Hey, Kit Kat Splat, welcome to the stream. Welcome to the chat. We're making spooky jewelry today. I think this is a good size charm. It'll dangle off the wrist kind of like that. I think that's a good size. I think I'm going to make each of my charms 17, like in a 17 millimeter box. I think that should be good. I think TwitchCon really did a lot for me because I learned a lot. Obviously, I met a bunch of really great people. There was a few of us hanging out earlier. Oh, I kind of wish it would have happened on stream. That would have been pretty amazing. But I accept that it happened before stream. That's fine. Hopefully, when I go partner, it'll happen on stream or on stage. I don't know if you watched the opening ceremonies. They brought somebody up and made them a partner up there. Yeah, we really had a really good table. So I met Kit Kat Splat at TwitchCon this weekend. And we had a table of us at, it was take your stream to the next level. And there was just like so many good people on there. We were hanging out on Meg's stream earlier. Hopefully everybody will come hang out on my stream. But yeah, it's been so good. All this spooky music kind of sounds the same. That's all right. I'll see. Okay, last time I tried to make a box, I realized I made it wrong. Why is this? This should be... Oh, it's because I'm still drawing with it. I actually don't want to do this box. I want to do this box. Okay, so I'm going to make you... What did I say? 17? 17 millimeters? Boom. Okay, so this is our space that we have to work with. But I've been really enjoying. I missed your stream earlier, Kit Kat. I was yesterday you were streaming. I saw on there, but I was out and about and my phone wasn't working. But I definitely am gonna check out your stream next. I like this little community we built at our amazing little table. Let me grab, let's see, my move tool. So the software I'm using, I don't remember if I told you guys at the table about it. This is called Rhino 3D. And it's typically used for architects and jewelers, which is kind of funny because they don't really make the same kind of objects. Because architecture is usually not always, you know, pretty straight versus jewelry, which has all these curves and things to it. Let's see, I want to find a picture of a pumpkin to use as a reference. The software is really nice because you can just import pictures. I want a cartoon pumpkin of like an object and use it as a reference to kind of trace over before poofing it up and making it three-dimensional. And I like to find pictures of like if I'm making like an object of like a cartoon because usually the shapes have been simplified for me. Because if you try to go off of an image of like an actual pumpkin with like all the lighting and how irregular they are, it can get a little difficult to kind of turn it into like a piece of jewelry. But cartoons have been simplified for you. So I just looked up pictures of pumpkins. And I'm just trying to find a cute one. I like how these are all a little misshapen. So I just have to decide if I want to do a misshapen pumpkin or if I want to do like our standard perfect pumpkin. I like these little three quarters because I'm not going to do like a full three-dimensional pumpkin because I'm going to do this for a charm bracelet. And so I'm going to do like the front half of the pumpkin and then punch the jack-o'-lantern pieces through. Let's see, that top pumpkin was pretty cute. That's funny. I might just go with that top pumpkin. Because it was pretty cute. Oh, that one's cute. This is the hard part, finding the image. I'm really feeling, where is it? This pumpkin right here. It's nice and simple. We should be able to get a face on there pretty easily. I like the extra little swirlies at the top. We'll have to thicken them up for jewelry to survive casting. But I'm really feeling this little pumpkin. Cartoon pumpkin. There we go. Okay, so we're just going to import this as a picture. Okay. So here's our cute little pumpkin. I'm going to trim him down so that he isn't sticking out past here. Cool. All right. He's going to be so cute. Oh, I like it. This is going to be the cutest spooky stream ever. And I'm hoping to make this bracelet actually available for purchase. I'm still working on getting my website up. I have a few things on Etsy, but I'm not doing very well on there. So I'm going to get a website up, and then the stuff that we design on stream where it's not for a client, I want to make available for purchase because I think that would be really fun. If we're going to all design stuff together, if then we can all like have a version of it or a copy of it, I think that would be so fun. We've got our beautiful little pumpkin that we picked out. I guess I picked out. We'll have to decide what kind of a face we want to put on here as well after I've made the actual pumpkin shape. I think I'm going to make each kind of lobe separately so I can control it. I just locked this layer so now I can't click on anything else. So let's see how I want to make this guy. I think he's actually even. Let me know what you guys think of our spooky music. Some of the music on this playlist have been, if you can even hear it, I don't know if you guys can hear it. Some of this music has been real spooky, and I'm like, I don't know if I'm happy with this, my choice to use this, this music. I'll have nightmares from my own stream. Let's see. See if I can get this to be what I want it to be with curve. Oh yeah, that's pretty cute. Yeah, there we go. Okay. Good guy. I think we decided to call this Spooktober to actually celebrate our Halloween. Alright, so we got our first little lobe done. I'm wondering, I'm gonna try and use, there's a tool called Two Rail Sweep, which is you make a surface out of you got like two curves that control the path of the surface and then curves that control the shape of it. So I think I want to do, I'm going to try that. Otherwise, I might have to get into Curve Network, which is a little bit more of a complicated tool for making surfaces. But that might be what we need to do. But I think this jack-o'-lantern shouldn't be too complicated. What am I doing? Curve tools. I want an arc. Let's do you. Should draw you in a different color. There we go. Because we do still want him to be sort of flat. Usually I don't make my surfaces an orange because I save that for anything I'm going to use to be a cutter. But since this is a pumpkin... All right, so there. Let's just see, and then a point. Oh, that's not what I wanted. Okay. That's fine, I can fix that. I think this needs to be three-dimensional. Oh, you know what? I might have to do like a blend, I might have to do a blend surface for the end here. Because, yeah, I like how this is looking. That's very pumpkin-y. Oh, I also did I did some jewelry casting the other day that I'm going to show off on stream a little bit later, too. So I've got my 3D printers up and running. And I've got things that I cast. So it was a good jewelry week so far. This week. See, Diego, you can also make a half revolve from the arc and then rebuild it. That's a good idea, too. So would I do, like, the half revolve from this guy? That could work, too. I like to do sweeps because I like to have that control over my curves. But that might work, too. I know that won't work for my side pieces. Let's see how that works. Let's see how that works. Let's do this. We haven't saved yet anyway, so we should save. This is not for her. This is for us. Oh, you know what? I need a new folder for designs made on stream. New folder. Streams. Oh, there we go. And this is a pumpkin. Pumpkin. There we go. Ooh. That's a spooky sounding song. Oh, this one's too spooky. Is that one too loud? I feel like this music is just coming in at so many different sounds. I need to be louder than the music. Ooh. I feel like Jason's gonna sneak up behind me or something. Freddy Krueger. Okay, so we've saved this, so let's see. I'm gonna have nightmares just from this music, guys. Okay, let's try a revolve and see if we like how that looks. Do fit curve to remove my control points, and let's see. I don't think, because revolve isn't one of my favorite tools. And then you think I should rebuild it? Rebuild. Let's see. How many control points do you think we should have on this? What is that? Oh, that's not enough. Because it kind of swapped it. So, I think maybe. And let's see, maybe 9? Well, it looks pretty usable. Yeah, I guess it depends on how poofy I want him to be. Ugh, I don't like this song. Alright. Let's see. So we're getting kind of sculpty in here today. That's fairly pumpkin-y, because these guys are going to puff out too. I don't hate that. I don't hate that. Let's save it. Okay. Now, but I don't think a revolve will work on these side ones, though. When did music boxes become, like, a creepy sound? I had music boxes when I was little. And I feel like they weren't as creepy as, like, this particular song that's playing. I think I still have to do a sweep on this. Unless I take him and mess with him. I think maybe control pointing might be too out of control for me. Too many control points going on here. Ah! I need to lock everything. Lock. There we go. Okay, now I can't click on it. There we go. No! Oh! There we go. Alright. Try to deselect these other points. Oh, that's kind of cool looking. Maybe I do just want to use my control points. I don't like this new feature in Rhino 6 where you can grab the objects while the control points are on. Yay! Oh my gosh, my first cheer! Yay! Oh, thank you, Darken! Thank you for the 1,000 cheers! Yay! Because, like, if I go like this, it's grabbing the whole pumpkin. I don't want to grab the whole pumpkin. Although, I am really happy with how this control point modeling is going. It's been a long time since I did control point modeling. Was there two surface points there? Okay. Let's just poof that out a little bit. That actually worked surprisingly well. Hype, 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 hype! Yay! This is so fun. I'm so glad I started streaming. Honestly, I've had so much fun. And, you know, I've already started to have... Our community is still pretty small, but I'm already really happy with our little community. Let's see how this looks in three dimensions. I think I'm going to bring these guys down a little bit. We're going to get super sculpty with this. So you don't need that. Now the question is do we want to keep everything even or do we want to go like full pumpkin on it and make everything uneven? Because that could look pretty cool too. And I think that's what I just decided as I start pulling these control points around. Is to go full pumpkin with it. I actually really like the way the bottom of this is looking too. Let me bring this up just a bit. Oops. Just grab these. Oh, I got too many control points on. This is why I don't usually model on the same color, but it's Halloween. It's a pumpkin. Who is causing me issues? Is it you? Yes, there we go. And then I think I want to bring this down because he's supposed to be a little bit rounder. I'm just going to make sure I don't fall into the trap of just grabbing control points and modeling and forgetting about the rest of the world. Because that definitely can happen while you're modeling. Ooh, what's going on here? Let's poof you up a little bit, friend. I think I want you guys. Ooh. Another spooky, super spooky one. There we go. That's the guy I want. And there we go. Okay. You need to be adjusted. Keeping those. So on the model, these are called iso curves, and they kind of allow us to see what our surface is doing. And so I like to keep mine as straight as possible. I've been watching, so I'm going to learn the software called ZBrush. And that was a tip I got actually from watching a ZBrush stream, because they model kind of the same way as I'm doing it right now with the control points and vertices and edges and things. So I'm just trying to keep all those lines nice and straight. All right, I don't really care what's going on under here because that's underneath the other pumpkin part, and that's okay. Aw, that looks pretty cute. Whoop. Aw, I like him. I like him a lot. Do I want this to be lower? Maybe I just want this one to be higher. Let's scale it. Let's see. Let me come to my transform tools. Grab my 1D scale. Do we like that better or do we like the other way better? Oh, I don't like that way now that I've seen this way. How thick is he getting? Oh, he's not getting too thick. Because I'm gonna hollow him out from the inside. I think maybe I just need to bring the sides down a little bit more. Mm-mm-mm. Let's do a 1D scale here again. Well, this music's so creepy, it's not even making noise. So we have a few other spooky things planned for the rest of the month. You can remove some knots and work with less control points without losing the shape. You think I can remove some? Should I just do remove knots? Would that be under surfaces? Would that be under control points? That should probably be under control points. Let's see. You? Well, actually, I already like the way that looks. Toggle. If I got rid of you. You just see a bunch of pixels from there. A bummer. Let's see. Maybe I can remove you. Maybe. No, not you. Maybe you. Nope, not you. Well, actually. Undo. Actually, that's not terrible. I just removed a whole bunch. I don't know how to make it look less pixely for you, because I already made the curves thicker. I don't want to make the ISO curves thicker, because if I make the ISO curves thicker, I'm not going to be able to see a darn thing on here, you know? Alright, so let's make... Oh, there we go. Oh yeah, look at that. That's so much easier, isn't it? Way less control points. Oh yeah, look at those are really tiny on the screen, huh? But I already like how this shape is coming out a lot better. Because now... Oh yeah, that's way easier. Oh, he's super pumpkin-y now! That was what I wanted. That's a very pumpkin shape now. Yeah, I think I just needed less control points. Oh, he's real cute! Oh, I really like our little pumpkin, guys. Okay. Oh, I want to fix this. I want you to be a little bit poofier. Just a smidgen. Just a smidgen. There we go. That's better. Bring you back over there. Cool. This is looking good. Yes, spooky pumpkin. Also filmed my setup of my 3D printer. So I can take a break and talk about my 3D printer for a second. So I set up my 3D printer, my brand new resin 3D printer, and let's see here. I love it so much. There's actually a print on it right now, so if it finishes during the stream, I'm gonna take a break, go clean it off, and then bring it back over. But I have a couple of prints off my new printer to show you, but I gotta turn off my Chrome key, so please pardon the green behind me. There we go. Ooh! Alright. Now you can see my beautiful green screen. So, this was off of the 3D printer, the resin one. And so, the resin ones, if you're not familiar, they print upside down like this. Something weird happened to my base. I'm not quite sure what went wrong there. But this is the little test print that they have. And it came out. I am really happy with the quality. We're going to test some castable stuff. And if it is castable, then I'm going to be so excited. But then I printed, this is the ring that we did, that we've been doing on the stream for the past couple of weeks for my sister-in-law. This is how tiny her finger is. Like, this is my pinky, and I don't have big hands. It doesn't even fit my pinky. It's so, so tiny. Yeah. Yeah, some guy, it's so tiny. That's why, like, the ring itself isn't that big. Like, on me, this would be a reasonable size, but I'm really worried about her hand that it's going to be like giant on it. But I really like how the... Let's zoom in on it. No. I really like how the design came out on it. It came out pretty cute. Yeah, I'm actually really surprised. The quality of the print is really good. And some gal, I'll post if I've got a castable resin coming in. I'm really happy with like the quality, the print quality. It's really hard to tell, but even the little hearts on the side came out. And so I'm really happy with that. Here we go. Now you can see the pumpkin again. So we're thinking classic Janko lantern or a cute one. Okay, that's perfect. We can do that. Yes. Whoop. All right. Bloop, back in my corner. All right, so let's finish making our cutesy little pumpkin. Then we'll make our thing. I'm thinking that the stem should come up and come back down, and that'll be where the jump ring for the, because this is going to be a charm bracelet, so I'm thinking that that will be where the jump ring will attach. So we'll take this, we'll wrap it around, maybe even add the leaf. I kind of like the leaf, but I don't want to get too detailed because I don't want to get too small with this. So let's see if I can just copy this guy over, and then let's scale him, because there's little extra modeling that we have to do, the better. And then we'll rotate him. Let's go to ghosted mode so we can see our picture. Oops. Not sure that wasn't bad. We'll put him there, and then we'll turn on our lovely control points, and we'll pull them down, 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 and back up, maybe over. Let's see how that's looking. It's not quite giving me the look that I wanted. I think we're gonna have to do some things. All right. Let's change these to that, so we're like a peachy pumpkin now. That way we can just work on this one area. Everybody else is locked, so I can't accidentally move them around. Another spooky music box song. There we go. This is what I want. Strangely deformed on the inside, but we don't care. Hey, this would work for our banana lantern, actually, guys. Check it out. We made a banana accidentally. Actually, it's almost like a fortune cookie. If I just folded it a little bit more, we've made ourselves a fortune cookie. Which, that would be a cute charm. Not for this particular bracelet, but we're going to... let's export this as banana base. Ooh, makes me want to eat banana now. We'll just call... Nope, this is not an STL, so we don't want to put it there. I want to put it in my cab. And streams. We'll call this banana base. Since we accidentally made a banana. Okay. Now you can go away. Now we'll unbananify this. I think let's try deleting some things and seeing if this is what I want. Oh, whoops. I might have just killed him. Oh, we're getting close, though. I might need to do a set point. Oh, I should make him see-throughable. See-throughable? Well, now we're making up words. Translucent? I should make him translucent. Let's do that. You selected. Wait. What's up with my options? Did I not select it? Is it not gray? Why are you not being selected, friend? Oh, because I unlocked the wrong thing. Like, it's not giving me what I want. There we go. Oops. There we go. Cool. Alright, let's do a set points and turn this back into a point. Oops. Now I need to go back and lock it again. Lock. And lock. Now we're locked and loaded. Nope, we're just locked. We're not loaded. Let's see. Let's do set points and turn these all back into a point. Set points. Okay. Did I miss one? I did. There we go. And then we can take these guys over here. Take these guys. Oops. Over here. What have I got going on? Yes. That's not looking so bad. Let's maximize this so you guys can see what I'm doing. Ooh, there we go. Oh, yeah. Now I'm happy. Now we're making a pumpkin. A spooky, cute pumpkin. It's probably he's going to be much cuter than he is spooky. That's okay. That to be inside there a little bit. Ooh, I like it. I like it. And so he looks in metal. Oh. I was like, what? He looks orange. He's not supposed to be orange. All right. Change objects layer. There we go. I think maybe it needs to come down just a little bit more on the side here. Because these look like they're on top. But other than that, I think he's looking pretty cute. Pretty pumpkin-y. I think I might leave it at that. I don't know. Let me know in the chat if you think I should do these little back pieces. I don't know. I haven't decided. Let me know what you guys think. Otherwise, I think I might just leave it as is. Like this. Maybe I should have left. I'm going to insert one knot on here. Let's see. Edit. Control points. Insert knot. I need one more. There we go. So what that did was it gave me, well, it gave me a few extra lines of control points so that I can kind of go in here and really start to sculpt him. Because I think I deleted a little too many. Oh, see, this is the kind of spooky music I wanted. Very Nightmare Before Christmas. Child Halloween. Need that. This almost sounds like an Inspector Gadgety song. Okay, I like that shape. How are we looking here? Looking okay. I think maybe poof you a little. Yeah, I'm not quite sure what perspective I want. That's true. If I want him to be a little bit more three quarters, then I would need the back. Decisions. You know, I'm getting a little thin over here now that I look at this. This is less than a millimeter right now. So I think I don't want to, because I'm actually already going to need to go in here and make this a little thicker to make it manufacturable. What are you doing over here? What's happening here? I need to find a whole playlist like this. There we go. You, is it you? Are you causing me heartache? Yes. There we go. And you, what are you doing over there? Got my control points all over the place, guys. These things have... Oh, I forgot you. There we go. There we go. This is better. There we go. Okay. I don't want to mess with it too much, because like I said, I could sit here for days messing with that. Let's see. What if... I pull that over. There he is. There's our little pumpkin. Our little pumpkin. Aw, aren't you cute? Let's save him. Well, you know what? We've got time. Let's go ahead and make the little back pieces. And if we hate them, then we'll delete them. If we love them, then we can keep them. Yeah? So we can go off of that. Let's see. I just saved. All right. Because I'm really excited to make the stem. I think that's going to be fun. That's going to cover up anything going on here, because I got a lot of weird surfaces overlapping. And we're not too worried about that, because eventually I'll union everything together and then use that to hollow it out from the inside. So we'll have a nice, even thickness going through here. So we don't have to worry about castability. This should be able to cast pretty easily. And if my new 3D printer ends up having castable material, which I have on the way, then I have to cast them myself, and I won't have to send them out and have them made, because that is so fun. So you could own a charm bracelet that we all designed together that I cast myself. So that's the real goal here. Okay, so... So... If I'm going to put these back pieces on, I'm going to have to move these points all up a little bit, yeah? Let's see, I saved, right? Yeah, I did. Okay. So let me grab you guys, because you're the parents. And let me grab this. Don't freeze on my computer. We don't have time for that. We got... So my friend picked it out. It was... Let me see. Actually, I have this chart for the materials that can be used on my particular 3D printer. Wow, that's bright. And so... Let me see which one she got. I know it was orange, but I don't think it was any cubic. It was a different company. Rapid. Let's see if it was on this. I know it's on the list. I just don't remember what. This one. Okay, we got Maker Juice Waxed Cast Orange. I knew it was orange. What is this? Is this being castable? Oh, look! Oh! Cool. And then, so this is like an open source chart that we found on Reddit that somebody started, where you can go in and they put this, you can even go in at the bottom, there's links to update it. So if you've tested something out, you can come in here and use it. So this is the one that we have coming in, Maker Juice Wax Cast Orange. And because I was done testing waxes or resins, I was done. I wasn't going to test anymore. I was like, I'm done. None of you work. You're all garbage. I hate everything. But my friend knew in my heart that I wasn't done testing, and so she was very easily able to convince me that we were not done testing. So I will, yeah, I'll give updates once I have tested it out. But really, pretty exciting. Shake your resin. That's funny. You always have to shake your resin. If you don't, then it settles and then it doesn't work very well. Oh, hey, little pumpkin. That should work, because then I can have the other ones kind of... Right? Okay. We're going to leave it flat for now. But I think I might need to pull those points up. So I'm not sure when the resin is coming. It has been ordered. I already got a new tray from my printer, so I don't have to clean out my current one, and we can just go ahead and switch. So hopefully, fingers crossed, this is the one. Because that's really what's been holding me back from my business. I wanted to be able to produce everything myself, but was unable to because these castable resins weren't working for me. I was pretty sad about it. Let's see, let's make all these guys here and then lock them. They're good for now. And let's make our little back of our pumpkin. I'm trying to decide what the best way of doing this is. Let me make a sphere and sculpt it, or I guess I could just do another sweep, rebuild it, and sculpt it. Let's do that. Let's see, we were modeling on the blue. This spooky music is much better. Funny, because I didn't change the station. Oh, it won't let me snap because I'm not in ghosted. Ooh. Ghosted. There we go. Meow. And then I need one profile in the middle. Let's just have you guys go away for a minute. Okay, profile. We'll just go to curves, draw our own, grab ourselves an arc. We don't need you to be... Oh, he is so thin. Yeah, I'm going to have to definitely make some more adjustments on here because that's not going to work. All right, two rail sweep. You. We'll go from a point to here and then to a point here. Good enough. We'll change you to orange since we're doing pumpkins. We'll lock you and we'll lock a blue. And then we're going to rebuild him. We can make him better. I did some research on types of castle resins, and that was the one that got good reviews on several blogs. Yeah, that's what my friend was saying. Was that one got a lot of good reviews because I have not, if I'm going to write reviews, because so far I'm not happy with how form printers castable material is. I'm not happy with 3D systems castable, and who else have I tried? Oh, I tried this other off-brand. It was garbage. It was probably the worst of them. I have some Envision Tech stuff. I should see if that will actually work on my printer because I bought a bottle of Envision Tech Emerald Green, and I supposedly it's supposed to be one of the really, really castable ones, and I still have the bottle. I bought it because I borrowed a 3D printer from a friend, and then their 3D printer broke, so then I didn't even get to use it, and I just spent like $100 for no reason because isn't that life? Oops. I just deleted my whole surface. I didn't want to do that. I just wanted to go in and delete some knots. Do I have it in my... remove knot. So let's get rid of you and you and you. And then let's get rid of... Who do I want to get rid of? Yeah, so hopefully it works, because if that castable resin works, and I bought a 3D printer for $260, and that resin works, I'm just going to be so mad at 3D printing worlds. Because if it was that easy from the beginning, what happened here? All right, let's see. Let's turn this little fella on. Well, that actually doesn't look too bad. He's so thin, though. Look at this guy. He's like a quarter of a millimeter. He is not even a reasonable surface. Oh, that's all right. We'll just make him look good, and then we'll make it castable or make it manufacturable after that. So funny. He's so tiny. He's a tiny little fella. Yeah, I think I'm going to have to pull all these points up and then maybe do like an extrude on the back to make them manufacturable. But I don't think he's, let's see, he is, no, I don't think he's too thick. I might be able to adjust this one up a bit. I'm trying to think. Let's unlock them. And let's save. And let's see if this can get scaled up and not ruin the look. Oh, so guys, I can get subs now as well. So if anybody has one of those Prime subs, has Amazon Prime, you can be my first subber. I don't have anybody subbing yet. I will have rewards for people who sub eventually, but if you want that coveted spot of my first sub, it is up for grabs. And the Prime subs don't cost you anything, which is wonderful. Since Amazon now owns, I think owns Twitch. Or is at least partnered with them. Shouldn't have clicked so high. That might actually work. Why am I clicking so high? Silly Kelly. Oh, there we go. That's much better. Oh. I don't need you to be that quite that high. Now it just looks like there's hair coming over the top of our pumpkin. I don't like it. I like that. I like that. Meh. Okay. So what happens when you're trying to flatten out something three-dimensional, right? It becomes a little wonky. Yeah, I think I'm just going to have to pull this up. I was going to have them be flat in the back like this, but I might have to add a little thickness to him. That's okay. Did I save? Did I just do that? No. Save. Okay. All right, so let's make the little last part of our pumpkin. Our pumpkin. I don't know why I decided to start saying pumpkin funny. Let's see. No, I'll draw it. I was thinking of taking an oval on here. Solid and just like editing it. Now, then I'm gonna have to rebuild it, and then I'm gonna have to shrink it to trim surface. I'll just sweep it like I have been. No need to do something totally wacky and out there. We are gonna switch layer colors. Let's make you pink or peach. Change object layer. Oh, that's too peach. Oops. I meant this guy. Yes, that's the same as everyone. And lock him. Yes, now I can't click on him. So let me hide them real quick so I can see what I've done. Let's grab another curve here. Grab myself an arc. If I go to the right bar at the top. Oh, I change it to this color. Oh, you know what? I didn't do this before. I should have had planner on. Oh, I did have planner on. Well, that's why it worked. I already had planner on. Lately, I've been modeling with planner on all the time, and I'm not mad about what's been going on with it. I think that might be my new normal, is to just leave that on all the time. And then we'll do point. So as I'm working on this, funny enough, this was like very similar to a project that we used to do at the school I used to teach at. It's like one of the very first projects was like learning how to model with control points. And it was something that like even me as a CAD modeler, I always forget that like, yeah, you don't have to control everything with the sweeps. You can turn your control points on. You can really start to edit and make sculptural things with that. It's something that I always forget about. But I'm glad that that's what where this ended up going. If I do 9 and 9, that looks good. And then I can go in and remove knots. So thanks, Diego, for reminding me that I could do that. As I do, I always forget that that's like a legit way of modeling stuff. And now I couldn't imagine trying to do this any other way. Oh, he needs to be thinner. I was worried about that. Because he actually needs to be there. I wanted to keep the back all flat. He needs to be an unreasonably thin surface. Okay, what if, let's lock you, these are my parent objects, what if I just grab these points, oh, I missed somebody, do you have your control points on, sir? I don't think you do. What if I just pull those up a smidge? I think that might actually fix the problem. It needs to be adjusted a little bit. Like, you probably didn't need those pulled up. And this is all going to be covered by the stem anyway. And that would actually fix a lot of the problems we were running into. Oops. The best part of this is that I can now take this after we're finished, print it on my 3D printer, and see if things are going to be too thin. So, oh, I'm so excited to finally have a 3D printer that can do jewelry. Let's see. You belong there? So yeah, if he does end up being too thin, I can just fix him later. You might actually need to go back to your home over... Oh, no. Over there? Is that good? That's looking pretty good. Think now. Yeah, I think we're doing good. I think he's good. I think now we can do our 3/4. I need you to be unlocked. Oh yeah, I can do like a panel at the bottom of like previously done projects. I've seen a lot of art people do that, where they've got like kind of what their last thing was they were working on, down below so you can kind of see what fun stuff happens on their stream. Oh, now we're getting Inception in here. Trying to find a control point. I did not find him. You go away for a second. You. That's who I wanted. Yeah, there we go. There we go. Yeah, because I got a lot of weirdness going on there. But the best thing is we're just going to put another surface over it so we won't even see that. So it won't even matter. Yeah, because that looks like garbage. But that's okay. I don't care. Because I don't have to care. Oh, I love our little pumpkin, guys. Are we going to name him? Is he going to have a name? Oops. I feel like I name everything Steve, so we can't name him Pumpkin Steve because that's silly. Yeah, and then we'll have the stem coming out. Okay, I'm super happy with how our little pumpkin is looking. Those almost look like little slugs. Oh, Diego. Oh, Diego, you shouldn't have said that, because now this is going to be a purple pumpkin. You can't tell me not to make something purple. Trust me, my husband has been trying since he met me to get me to stop making everything purple. I can even make it different shades of purple because I have a whole purple section of layers. I actually have a purple sparkly glitter pumpkin that I always try to like put out in the house, and my husband will be like, "That's not scary." I'm like, "No, it's scary to you." Yep. Right, you cannot stop this purple. Now I'm gonna make the stem purple. Oh, let's see. For our stem, what should I do? Ooh, Apollo the purple pumpkin. Ooh, I like the alliteration. All right, so we got Apollo the purple pumpkin. That's vote one. We have till the end of the stream to decide what we're going to name her. She's a girl now. She's purple. Well, I guess boys could be purple, too. Most of my stuff ends up being female because that's what I do. No. Now my husband has someone on his side. I don't like that. We'll never stop with the purple. Oh, that music was so perfect for that. Oh. Purple is a cult, I'm telling you. Once you join the purple cult, it's forever. You'll never be able to get out of the purple cult. Now we're going to do purple and blue, because I like blue. So I'm thinking for the stem. Oh no, my chat has turned against me. It's like, who was somebody was pro purple last time. I need some pro purple in here. Where's my mother? Is she not in the chat? No! Rotten pumpkins are green or white. Trust me. I live in San Diego. Oh! It's not ugly now, it's beautiful. How does purple not bring you joy just to look at it? It's just such a happy color. I think this was actually the color of the wall in my bedroom when I lived alone. I'm gonna have to call my mother and tell her to get on here and help me defend purple. My mom's actually, her favorite color is blue, but at least I know I'd have someone on there. It's a spooky pumpkin. Witches are purple. Purple's a Halloween color. Purple and black, right? That's super spooky. I just want to see kind of how this is going. I don't usually, I'm going to make it purple. I don't usually do pipe for stuff, but lately I've noticed that pipe actually works really cool for making stems. Because if you add like another point, it actually does stems okay. Let's turn off our gray. Oops. This is going to give a lot of my chat nightmares because it's so purple. I might add a few more, like, spots for the pipe on here. But he's not looking so bad. He's not looking so bad. He's actually looking great. Color choice was a good decision. I need my dog. She's on my side with purple. She's dressed like a Sailor Scout, and she's Sailor Saturn, because that's the purple one. I like the first half of your suggestion. The second half, I don't know. Oh, wait, look. Now I can be sad. Chat, you're making me sad. I got this at TwitchCon. And it just so happens to work right now. Rose, come here and help mommy spread the good word of purple. So mean. So sad. Rosie! Doggy num num! My dog is abandoning me. Everyone's abandoning me. I kind of like how it's got that weird bump in it. This doesn't need to be this big either. So sad. This is the sad stream. This isn't the spooky stream. This is the sad stream. I actually really like how that's looking. I probably will explode it. And then rebuild it and make it a little bit more organic-y. Oh, I forgot to put a rounded cap on it anyway. Let's see. I just want to make sure this comes out to be the right size. This is looking okay. This might actually work on a necklace, too. Where's my little Sailor Scout? Rose! Doggy Num Num, baby girl. I think she knows. I think she's learned that if I'm sitting at the computer and I just call her and tell her there are treats, even my child has abandoned me. This is what it's like to have children. Yes, I made food noises. All right, we got double food noises. Maybe she can come. There she is. Wait, wait, wait. Don't pull down the green screen, baby girl. Alright, that's enough, husband. Ugh. See? Oh, it's getting dirty. What? What? Oh, yeah, you see the cheeses. Alright, hang on. Let me show off your cosplay. So this is her Sailor Saturn outfit. Ah, Rose girl, you got sharp toenails. I got this at TwitchCon. They had this cute girl. I'll have to remember the name of it. Welcome to the chat, BH Donnie. Yeah, we're doing a Halloween-themed one instead of our usual K-pop. And the chat has turned against me and is voting against purple, which is why everything is purple now. Husband. My chat has turned against me, Rose. Comfort me. Comfort me. My hair matches her. See? Look, we match. We're matching mother and daughter. No. Baby girl. I need you to get the chat back on my side. Do a little dance so that they love you. She doesn't love me. Okay, 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 okay. You good? You good? You good? All right. Do the purple dance. Do the purple dance. Do the purple dance. I love purple. I love purple. Hi, tortured soul. Show off your love of your mother's favorite color because you don't have a choice because you're a dog. Oh, she's so tortured. Okay. All right, fare thee well. Fare thee well, my child. Here you are. Cheese it for your tortured times. Okay. We'll need a cool name for our stuff. I was thinking Sparkle Squad because it was hilarious. We could all be part of the Sparkle Squad. My other friend also thought it was hilarious because it was so silly. But I don't know if y'all want to tell everybody you're part of Cute Jewelers Sparkle Squad. You know that this is just making me want to make all my new emotes purple. The color that shall not be named, that's orange. I was making an orange pumpkin. I actually hate the color yellow. What has happened? My creations are turning against me, Rose. Oh, she left again. I don't even have Rose. This is the meanest stream ever. I think I like that this is a little wonky. Do I want to change it? I think I'm going to leave it. So while I cry about my chat, I think I want to make these all one object so I can extrude the edge and fix this area. Yes, this is what I would like to do. Would a bullion work on this? Yeah. Oh, no, that one didn't work. And that's okay. Oh, even my exclamation marks were purple now. I think if I do this? No. I might have to do trims. It's like it knew. It's even making my exclamation marks purple. Oh, you know why? It's because they're not, yeah, that's why. Well, at least those worked, right? So maybe what I need to do is duplicate the border of everybody, extrude it now, cut it then, and then bullion union everything together. Yes? Yeah. Yay! So I'm so excited. I got my first subscriber! Yay, thank you for the Prime! Play it again! I got my first subscriber! Got my first subscriber! Do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do! Yay, thank you for the Prime! All right, don't aim too high. Don't aim too high. Yay! Thank you, Darken. Thank you. My first subscriber. You'll always have a special place in my heart. Oh, yay. What a good day. I'm sure I'll convince you eventually. Meg had a good stream earlier today. And then she got gifted like a 3-tier sub from one of the streams. That was amazing. Yay! Yeah, I had a lot of fun on your stream. It was great to have like our whole table. Well, not our whole table, but like half. Like, yeah, that was like half of our table from our Friday panel was there. And Kit Kat was here earlier. We had a really good group. Oh, I want grid snap. Here we go. And we're making a pumpkin charm today. Yeah, there was just a few, and I think a couple of them were actually streaming while you were streaming. I think, or it could have been somebody I met at a different panel. I was only there for the one day, so I didn't get to meet as many people as you did. But it looks like you met a lot of people, which is so fun. But yeah, thanks to your, actually, you were my 49th follower, Meg. And then someone from your stream was my 50th. It was, Taquitos. Taquitos was my 50th. Oh, I love that. I love that. I didn't realize you were there by yourself because I was also there by myself. So we could have just, like, teamed up. Because I also didn't know anyone. Yeah, they want 3D printed business cards from me, which I'm totally down to do. I'll probably start having those up on Etsy because they went over really, really well. I got them here. I didn't give away as many as I hoped, but the promise is that, like, just having, like, a few. Yeah, these things ended up being so thick, but I was really happy with how they had come out. But yeah, I think Taquitos wants some. BH Donnie, you love taquitos with guac and cheese. Mm. Oh, now I want some guac. Ooh. Yay! My second subscriber! BH Donnie, I will go and I will make you a special welcome that doesn't have a K-pop star just for you. Oh, that's so fun. They came to a meetup. Yeah, we had such a great group. I wonder if the other tables were as wonderful as ours. I can't imagine. Well, I don't know. I just don't know if they would be because our table was just so good. I don't know if we got lucky or if that's just how it is, you know? Nope. Oh, this little pumpkin's so cute. He's so cute. I think our table was just so good. And everybody was so, like, I hear a lot of streamers talk about how, like, introverted they are, which I thought was kind of funny because I'm, like, a super extrovert. Yeah, so everybody at our table, I don't think anybody streamed the same thing. Yes, yeah, so Twitch Prime subs have to do it. You have to manually do it every month. That's the kind of one downfall of it. It doesn't cost you anything, but you do have to actively do it. Oh, whoops. But hopefully you'll be loving my channel and want to do that every month. I'm so excited. I got two subs. let's see. I need to change the directions of these. I've heard a lot of streamers recently who didn't go to TwitchCon, even a few that did, that said they were like introverts. And I'm like a super extrovert. And so I was under the impression that all Twitch streamers were extroverts, which apparently I was wrong about. So, because then everybody, I talked to a bunch of people, which usually my introverted friends, when they're with me at places, are like, stop talking to people. So I don't know if it was just that, like, everybody was just so friendly and excited to be there that they were talking to everybody, or if, you know, they were just what's the word, just all extroverts that I happened to talk to. But recently finding out that a lot of streamers are actually introverts, I was very surprised. Yeah, it was probably that there was just so much hype and everybody was just so excited that it was like, I gotta talk to everybody. But I loved it. I met so many nice people. Fortunately, I didn't have any of the bad experiences that a few streamers had. From guys, next year I'll take you with me. Yes. Because I plan on still streaming by then. Let's see. I think I just do this. What? Oh, I have grid snap on. I was like, why was that so snappy? And then cut it. I think that will fix that problem. Yes. Okay. I'm taking a sippy cup next year. Yes. So chat, if you didn't hear, a couple of streamers got roofied at TwitchCon, which is just so crazy to me. But, I mean, it just goes to show that, you know, you got to be vigilant everywhere you go. But, yeah, and they also had, I learned all this from Meg's stream earlier, actually, that they had, like, open alcohol just hanging out in the partner booth, but there are, like, children who are partners. Yeah, hopefully next year they'll get their act together. I think this was probably the biggest TwitchCon they've had so far. I don't know how the European ones went, but from what I was hearing from everyone, this was the biggest TwitchCon they've had. Which is exciting because it's only going to get bigger. And hopefully we can convince more people to stream CAD. Oh, wait, you know what? I didn't want to do that yet. Because I still have to hollow this out. Type cap. There we go. Cap. But, I mean, I still had a lot of fun. And I know you did, and everybody, all of our table all had a lot of fun. So right now what I'm doing is I'm making a copy of the original object so that I can hollow it out. And since we're sticking with everybody's favorite color, I'm going to keep everything purple. Yeah, from guys, I am so excited that it's in San Diego again. We're going to have so much fun. Maybe I should have fixed that before. Yeah, okay. I'm going to have to fix this. I didn't want to. How do I want to fix you? Because this will fix it, but I need it to be fixed. Oops. I turned off all the purple. I just wanted to turn off that one. This one will have to be fixed before I hollow it out because I don't want that weird little pokey thing. Let's see. What do I want? How do I want to fix? From guys, I normally love that emote, but now I feel it's a little tainted for me. I know it's because you love purple and so your heart is just crying for purple. what is happening here? I don't want you. Do I have intersect on? I do have intersect on. Quad. That should be good. That's why I like custom, is because you can kind of go in and you can do whatever you need to, do whatever you want to a model to make it, you know, comfortable for the person. I think 3.5 is the smallest I've ever made a ring for someone. I don't think I've made anything smaller, but this is by means not the first 3.5 I've done. But on the opposite side, I did a ring, this ring. Zooming back and forth here. This ring is for a woman who wears a size 10 3/4, which is not the biggest ring I've ever done and either. But you can go a lot bigger on your pattern. So I was making this ring for her and I was worried that it was going to be too big because it's like my size of a ring and I like a big bulky, you know, in your face pieces of jewelry. So I was worried that it was going to be too big on her because it's a big ring, but she's got big fingers. So she tried it on. It was perfection. So I was really happy about that. So yeah, so it just gives you different things to work with. One of the challenges with small rings is that you don't want to add too much detail to it. So like yours, where you've got just the heart, is good because it's not too much. Like if it was a bigger heart or if it had a heart and then it had like, you know, lungs or ribs or something around it, then it's starting to get too much and then you can't wear it. But I really like that ring. I want to do a whole anatomical jewelry line, but that's already been done. But I do like taking things that aren't necessarily jewelry. I mean, there's a lot of pumpkin jewelry out there, too. But listen, this guy's cute. All right, so let's make a copy. So we'll just hollow him out. And then I'll have to see how I'm doing on time. I'm not sure what time I'm supposed to go meet for lunch. Or sorry, dinner. It's not lunchtime. I did have lunch. I had lunch already. 1.6. I'm just trying to make sure I have like an even 0.72. Okay. So I need to make you a little bigger. I'm trying to make this like 1 millimeter thickness all the way around. Or about that. 0.99. Okay, we're close. But I don't want it to be too thin. Otherwise it won't cast well. There we go. This is epic music. That's good. So we'll just move this down. Oops. Oh, sorry. Negative 0.07, not 0.07. Ooh. I can make you a shark pendant. Ooh, yeah. Send me a picture. A cartoon works best, but if you send me a picture of a shark, we can turn it into a pendant. That actually would still go with my Halloween theme, right? Just a hair more. That would be fun. I like making weird things. Actually, so I'm going to be doing, I'm going to be learning a software live on stream. And a shark would actually be perfect for it. So I'm going to be learning ZBrush, which is like a sculpting software. Let's see. I think I might need to make this thinner as well, or thicker. This looks a little thin. Oh yeah, this needs to go in this way a bit. Oh, that's really cute. Ooh, I like that. That's really cute. Let me show everybody. Yeah, so this one would be perfect. So when I do my I'm learning ZBrush stream, I can make this in that software. And that would come out really good. Ooh, fun. Fun ideas. I love it. Because you need a shark pendant for your stream. So Meg's stream is all like sea life themed, which is so fun. Because you play, I was just watching you play it. Yeah, I will. I'll make it and then price it out for you. Because we can do it in whatever metal you want to as well. So if you wanted like a dressier version, we could do gold. If you wanted, you know, a less expensive version, we could do silver. So we can, yeah, once I make it, we can too. I'll figure out like about what size you want it to be. I would go bigger rather than small. Yes, Sea of Thieves. I would go bigger as opposed to smaller so that you can get more pattern on there, but we can also simplify it and make it small too. Yeah, so Meg plays Sea of Thieves, which I had never seen played before, but it looked really fun. Because you were just going in looking for treasure the whole time, which I know isn't the whole game, but that looked really fun. I like to just like explore. It looked like a really big area you could explore. All right, so let's hollow this out. Our beautiful purple pumpkin. Oops. No, I don't want to union you. I want to... What's happening? I'm clicking on too many things. There you go. Cuteness. Now he's hollow. Hollow. Oh, which means I need to fix... Oh, no, that's perfect still. Yeah. Oh, he's really cute. And purple. Purple. That's what my friends say when they're in imitating me, actually. I want to do... Right, I can make a triangle with the square. Yeah, that's right. So I can use the square tool to make a triangle, which is funny. Beep. Yep. Okay. So there's his eyes. And we want, like, standard smile with, like, how many teeth should he have? 2, 3, 5. How many teeth do we want our little pumpkin to have? Back to calling him a pumpkin. Let's do grid snaps. And then I can turn off my grid snaps. I think his mouth can be wider. 3? 3? We got 2 votes for 3. All right, I think that's gonna be our winner. 2 on the top, 1 on the bottom? Is he too smiley? No, I liked it better. Big. Big old smile. Do we want, let's see, squares. A square. This is more like epic music. Actually, I kind of like that. Let's not make him even. Ah! Oh, because everything is history enabled. I'm thinking uneven because I've never, I don't know about you guys, but whenever I carve a pumpkin, his teeth never come out even. All right, there's no purple on the screen for a moment, Diego. That's a cute little smile. Yeah. I like it. I like it. I like it. Oh, they're not planar. That's fine. Oops. Oh, wait. No, this guy. Oh, what have I... Oh, I see. His teeth didn't line up. That's what's not planar. All right. Well, let's fix that. Project to seaplane. Delete input. Yes. And then join. There we go. All right. Now it'll work. No, these people who, like, carve these, like, amazing, super intricate pumpkins, I'm just so impressed by because it's like, I have never, ever made a pumpkin look like that. Let's see. The closest I did, so, did I close my Instagram? Oh, I did. That's all right. I posted a picture of a Dalek pumpkin that I did, which was actually, oh, Rose is sleeping next to me like a good little companion. I did a pumpkin, I was gonna name Rose Dalek, but then my brother was like, nobody's gonna be able to say that. It's like, okay, fair. He's also like, that's a bad guy. Do you want to name your dog after a bad guy? And I'm like, yes. I know, I'm gonna get a Rose cam because I think that that would be the best. Yay! Oh, he's really cute. Do we like his tooth like that? That's okay. That's okay. Let's turn this into metal. Yes! I love him! Yay! We did it! I do. I like the snaggle tooth too. I think it gives him a little bit more character. I guess he's turned into a... He was a girl at the beginning. Now he's a woman. I'm glad I still went with, like, the three-quarter style pumpkin. I think that those little loops add just a little bit to it. Oh, he's not flat on the back. That's okay. I didn't want him to be because he's going to hang. Ha! Diego, your hatred of purple breaks my heart. Makes me so sad. Now he's got purple hair. What if I did it in purple gold? Because that's a thing. If I really wanted to get intricate with him, I could cast him in 2 different colors. Actually, he probably should be yellow gold, huh? Black gold's fun. Black gold is hard to cast, so usually you put like a rhodium, a black rhodium plating on it. So it can wear off, but I also really like black gold too. So I could do his little, this little guy in black gold. Metal. Let's see. Let's make this black gold. There we go. Yeah. Oh, he's really cute. Yay! Woo! Awesome. Well, I'm going to make him available for sale. I'm going to get my website up hopefully this week, and then all the stuff can be ordered. He's so cute. I'm going to do, over the next month, I'm going to do Fruito Lanterns. So we started with a pumpkin, and then we're going to move into, I think we're going to do a banana next because that was requested last stream. And then, you know, if you want to see any other fruits made. Can we see it in ray trace? Okay, so I'm gonna switch it to ray trace, but just a heads up, it does make my computer a little slower, so if I get laggy, I'll have to switch out of it. So ray trace is the better rendering software. Let's get him a good angle. There we go. Oh, he's got no ground plane. Give him some shadows. Let's make him look real. There we go. So hopefully I'm not too laggy now. I think I look okay. I could do another version where I do enamel in his face as opposed to the cutout, or I could put black in there. We'll go back to rendered. Well, he looks better when he's got like ground to sit upon. I love him. I think he was turned him into a boy, though. You know what? Maybe he needs some eyelashes. Then he can go back to being Paula. We finished our first Fruito Lantern, which I'm very excited about. Thank you, everybody, for coming and hanging out. Guys, I'll be streaming again on Thursday, same time. Maybe we'll do a Halloween-themed. Maybe we'll go back to other jewelry. But other than that, thank you guys for hanging out. And I will see you guys on Thursday.